mind to the beat with my hopes and my dreams like a boat in the sea. Let it ride from the west and the east. Be the best you can be. Let the rest in peace while I try. What's goody, fam? You already know who it is. It's Shaka Shine, and I'm coming back at it with another reaction on Shaka Shine Reacts. Today, I gotta give a big old shout out to Travis, and their request was Archie Bunker, and this is a compilation of him. So, for the people that have been hitting that like button, hitting that subscribe button, hitting that comment button, this is a channel of giving credit where credit's due, and y'all deserve all the credit, so I gotta say thank you. I really appreciate it. With that being said, some of y'all are still sleeping on my music, so if you want to check out my music, links right underneath the like button. For the people that are waiting on their requests, as you can see, we get to every single one of y'all. If you want to skip the line, though, you can always hit me with a donation. Again, links right underneath the like button, and I'll make sure I'll get your reaction out within 72 hours. Now, as far as Archie Bunker goes, we're starting to do a little bit more All in the Family reactions, so let's go. I'm down with it. I assume that this is going to show me why this couldn't air today. So if this is your first time seeing one of my TV reactions, make sure you check out the playlist. We're growing it every single day. And if you're coming back for another TV reaction, then I'm not going to hold y'all. Let's get straight to it.
An American history lesson. You don't know nothing about Lady Liberty. Standing there in a harbor with a torch on high, screaming out to all the nations of the world, send me your poor, your deadbeats, your filthy. And all the nations sent them in here. They come swarming in like ants. Your Spanish PRs from the Caribbean.
Wow.
Your Japs, your Chinamen, your Crouch and your Heaves, and your leading fans.
Jeez. You're hard.
Come in here, and they're all free to live in their own separate sections. Where they feel safe, and then bust your head if you go in there.
Okay.
That's what makes America great.
Some of these doctors will tell you anything you want to hear.
This is the best there is.
Hold on. Let me turn this down a little bit, because I cannot deal with that.
When it comes to blood, my own cousin from the hospital said so.
Your cousin from the hospital empties bedpans. Don't make him out no specialist. I know what Dr. Feinberg said.
Feinstein,
Feinberg, it all comes to the same thing, and I know that tribe.
Oh, wow. That's dirty.
I'm telling you, Archie, them kids don't leave this house until Mike can provide for her proper.
Oh, boy. 4 years before I even begin to make a living. Seems like forever.
Well, let me tell you, sonny boy, the same thought crosses my mind at least once a day.
Mom?
Gloria, you married the laziest white man I ever seen.
Wow.
It's bad enough you gotta make fun of me. You don't have to make it worse by attacking a whole race.
Who's attacking a whole race?
You are. You just said I was the laziest white man you ever met.
What's the matter with that?
White man you ever met?
Yeah, you.
Implying that the blacks are even lazy.
Oh, no, wait a minute, meathead. You said that. Not me. I never said your black beauties was lazy. It's just their systems is geared a little slower than the rest of us.
Wow.
Names like black beauties for.
Now that's where I got you, Mr. Liberal. Because there's a black guy that works down the building with me, and he's got a bumper and sticker on his car that says black is beautiful. Huh? So what's the matter with black beauties?
It's nicer than when he called them coons.
Wow. That's definitely true. Jeez.
Help me, boy. Now I gotta change the shades.
Hey, I don't like that.
Hold on. I gotta go back.
Gotta change the shades.
Am I missing something? Hold on.
Sorry, don't help me, boy. Now I gotta change the shades.
Hey, I don't like that.
You don't like what?
Boy.
You call me boy. I'm not a boy. I'm a man.
Well, look, I'm a man too. Jeez, I don't go around making a point of it.
You never had to make a point of it.
Well, what are you looking at?
You know, it's amazing how someone can be so consistently wrong. I don't believe the things you say.
Because you're an atheist. You don't believe nothing about religion.
Look at what they say when they sneeze.
What?
Who's that, Edie?
The Chinese.
Wow.
I mean, do they say God bless you or Buddha bless you?
You really want to know? The chinks just sneeze and say nothing. They can't speak English.
Wow. Okay. Okay, I'm starting to see it.
Why couldn't they say Buddha bless you in Chinese?
Because they don't say that. That's why. They say, well, if they say anything at all, it's sayonara.
That's Japanese.
Same thing.
Wow.
It's not the same thing.
At all.
What are you talking about? You put a Jap and a chink together, you're gonna tell me which is which?
That's right, because I find out about them. I talk to them as individuals.
Sure, you talk to them. You say, which one of you guys is the chink?
Oh, wow.
He traced me from the address I give to send us the picture, you know who's...
This is, okay, I'm starting to see it now. I remember doing a couple of episodes saying, I don't understand why, but I don't understand why this couldn't be aired today. I'm starting to find out.
A car. That's right. He's in a limousine right now with a phone. Oh, I want to tell you, some of these colors are real class. Well, they got it. They spend it. I gotta call Munson right now.
I gotta go fix my face.
Watch. What do you mean some of these colors are classy? Why do you always have to label black people this or that? Because when they deserve a compliment once in a while, I don't know.
Wow.
Now, will you get away from me? My right
now, Edith, you don't have to be nervous with a colored crowd. Just keep your eye on me.
The answers are all right here in this sculpture. Take, for instance, what...
Get this turned back up.
This represents... This here is the struggle of the races. Man's inhumanity to man. Yet through it all, the shining hope of a new brotherhood, see?
You don't see it.
The girl has gone base. I'm all alone here. I'm all alone in this house. Isn't anybody else interested in upholding standards? Our world is coming crumbling down. The coons are coming.
Ooh. Yeah. Hit it.
12% of the population is black. There should be a lot of black families living out here.
Yeah, this is only a beginning, but I think it's wonderful.
Wonderful, huh? Well, let's see how wonderful it is when a watermelon rinds come flying out the window.
Wow. Sorry, I gotta keep turning this up and down because apparently there is no volume control on here, on this video itself. Looked like he saw a ghost. Is he always smoking a cigar too? Is that kind of his trademark? Let me know. Put it in the comments, please.
Some people.
Tell me who the people are.
Linda and Lionel.
Now what are Linda and Lionel doing in a picture?
They're sitting together
on a couch.
Not having none of that.
You're sitting together on a car!
Come quick!
No, this is the kind of fun she's having in our house, huh?
What's
weird about? What's going on? This is going on.
Wow.
And this is going on!
Well, wait a minute. Shouldn't we wait for the doctor, huh?
I am a doctor. I am on the staff here.
Whoa. You know what? You're a regular doctor?
You're
only at night. By day, I strangle chickens for the colonel.
That was a good one.
Well, go ahead, Edith. Now answer the guy. Now, you've seen Roger sashaying around here with his la-di-da talk. He's a pansy.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I'm not an expert on flowers.
You might as well face it. You're all alone in this. We all know Roger, and we all know he's straight. And even if he wasn't, and I said if, what difference would that make? Do you know that in many countries, England, for instance, there is a law that says whatever two consenting adults do in private is their own business?
Listen, this ain't England. We threw England out of here a long time ago. We don't want no more part of England. And for your information, England is a fag country.
Wow. Okay.
Are they still picking handkerchiefs out of their sleeve?
I see why this can't air today.
Are they still standing around?
And we're only 8.5 minutes through a 33-minute video.
On them skinny umbrellas like this here? I know. The whole society is based on a kind of a fagdom.
You know you're right, Archie. You're right. The British are a bunch of pansies. Pansies, fairies, and sissies. And the Japanese are a race of midgets. The Irish are boozers. The Mexicans are bandits.
And you Polacks are meatheads.
Open your presents. Russell wanted to send them over, but I insisted on bringing them over in person.
Well, Russell's way was better.
Oh, my, Archie, look.
Looks like gypsy underwear.
Wow.
It is a moo-moo.
Oh, it's beautiful.
A moo-moo.
Thank you.
Archie has a Hawaiian shirt.
Oh. Well, this could be the wallpaper in a fag bar.
Wow. He goes straight for the throne.
I'd be asking, but does your husband do a lot of the cooking over your house?
He does all of it. He loves it.
Oh, well, ain't you a little afraid of what people could think?
You mean that I'm a lazy wife?
No, that he's a fag.
Wow.
What is this crap hole you get? Care what you call it. You realize you spilled cheese in the potatoes?
You spilled cheese in the potatoes? That's good.
It was supposed to be there. The recipe called for it.
Are you telling me that somebody wrote in a book that you're supposed to put cheese in my potatoes?
There you go again. Anything that you haven't seen before, anything that's a little bit different, you're against. Before you were against French art, now you're against French cooking.
Let me tell you this. To the French.
They gotta get this volume control too. I'm sorry. I know that's gonna be hard for y'all to hear some of these, and some of it's gonna be extremely loud. I'm sorry. I'm telling you that right now.
I'll tell you something else about the French there, wise guy. You know why they lost World War II? Because when the Krauts was marching into their country, the French was running around naked, putting up dirty statues and throwing cheese in the potato.
Wow. Okay, let's go.
But Archie, how did the Germans know they was French if they didn't have no clothes on?
They knew they was Frenchy because they had cheese all over them.
Because they had cheese.
I don't want to argue with you. I'm just stating a fact. All blood is the same.
Well, if all blood is the same, let me ask you this. How come they ain't got no Swedes in the mafia?
What's that got to do with anything?
For real.
Because your Italians got a lock on it, that's why. It's in their blood. The same way it's in your black's blood to do the Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Wow.
What? Well, how do you expect them to sop up the gravy? What do you want me to do?
I don't know. All I know is you're ruining
They need to stop screaming.
For a minute, I thought I was in a back room of a Greek restaurant.
Wow.
Who said the treatment of...
I'm gonna be real. I'm gonna just be stuck saying wow. This whole video is just a video of a wows. I'm sorry.
The American Indian was a national disgrace.
Treating the American Indian a national disgrace. Geronimo? Come on, it had to be some Indian that said that. Who?
President Kennedy.
That's a lie. Kennedy never said that. Or maybe he said it, but he didn't mean it. He maybe said it when he was running for office and trying to get the Indian vote, but you never got any.
How do you know?
Because, Meathead, the Indians don't vote.
Oh, Archie, the Indians were given the vote in 1924.
I ain't talking about that. I'm saying that they don't use their vote like a fella told me. They sell all their horses for booze and then they can't ride into town.
Wow. So, I'm telling you, sorry, this is gonna be a whole bunch of wows. It is what it is.
That ain't stupid, that's the truth. That's what the Indians do to us after all we've done for them.
All we've done for them, Arch! Let me tell you something about this country and the American Indians and all we've done for them. We lied to them, we cheated them, and then we drove them off their land without paying for it.
That's right. What are you talking about their land? They never had no land. They couldn't read or write. How'd the Sitting Bull sign a lease? Ride around scout the wagon train.
Wow.
What would you do if somebody cheated you out of your land?
Well, I wouldn't scout the guy, I'd hire myself a lawyer.
I don't believe it!
Yeah.
How do you deal with this
lunacy?
Help me!
What are you yelling about? I ain't talking about the Polacks, I'm talking about the Indians.
So bad.
Oh, I know him, a typical out for himself Irish Mick.
What was Archie supposed to be? This was funny, is the fact of nowadays, like, I know that there was some pretty big race wars pretty much about the Irish, you know what I'm saying? No Irish need apply and all that in America. But what was the races that were okay then? You know what I'm saying? Because pretty much, what is Archie? What is he supposed to be from? Is he supposed to be from German? A German person, you know what I'm saying? Germany? Or is he supposed to be... Because he doesn't like the French. Doesn't like the Irish. Like, what is he? Like, where does his ancestors come from? I want to know that.
You just said.
I don't like it either. I mumble over my beach too. I'm Italian.
Oh, geez. I mean, you know, I couldn't tell it. Irish and Italian. Hey, look what we got here, read it. Mixed marriage.
What means? We're both Catholics.
Look, your phone's fixed. Frank, I think we better go.
Yeah, well, don't run away, because Edith's going to put coffee and cake on the table. Get it.
I'm sorry, but you know us Irish Catholics. I got to go have a few drinks and then rush right off to confession.
What do you mean, rush? What's the rush?
This is one confession that can't wait.
Oh, come on. A nice lady like you, what would you have to confess?
What I'm thinking about you.
Whoever it is bought Bowman's house must be doing pretty good if he can lay out $8-$10 a day for a cleaning woman.
$10? Oh, they're getting more than that for good cleaning people today. Maybe she's a live-in maid.
Wow, what are you talking about, Edie? The only people nowadays can afford live-in help are rich people and Jews.
Not all Jewish people are rich.
I never knew one that wasn't.
Wow.
The Steiners from our old neighborhood weren't. They didn't have as much as we did, even.
To hear them tell it. Hey, you don't suppose Bowman sold his house to one of that tribe, do you?
He calls them tribes.
He was always a jerk, but
He wouldn't do a thing like that to this neighborhood, would he?
Well, what I'm wondering is if a rich Jewish person could afford to hire a maid, why would he buy Jim Bowman's old house?
To make trouble, Edith, that's right.
Just to make trouble.
These people are always looking to make a test case.
Wow.
What do you think they got at their organization there? What do you call it? B'nai Bris. What?
I don't know what he's talking about right there.
Well, I'm going to go over there and find out.
Where are you going?
Well, I'm just going to take a walk over to Jim Bowman's house, and I'm going to talk to him about it.
If you think he's prejudiced.
Prejudiced?
Yeah.
Against who?
Against black people.
Against black people? Mr. Bunker? Well, that's the most ridiculous thing I ever heard.
There, you see that nice guy? You thought you knew him, you thought you knew me. Oh, these liberals. They're supposed to be so sensitive, you know? Well, I'll tell you where this guy's sensitive, Lionel, right in his tuchus.
Where? It's a Yiddish word. It means...
I know where it's at. I was just wondering, Mr. Bunker, what's with the Jewish word?
Oh, well, I hear them. We got a couple of heaps working down the building.
Does he use words like that very often?
Now and then.
I told you, I work with a couple of Jews.
Begging your pardon, Mr. Bunker, but you wouldn't happen to be one of them, would you?
What?
Well, I mean, people don't use Jewish words just like that, do they, Mike?
No, not in my experience.
Well, maybe people don't, but I do. And I ain't no Yid.
Well, come to think of it, when your father was visiting last year, wasn't his name Davy or something?
My father's name is David.
David, right. And then what was your mother's name? It was
Sarah. Sarah, yeah. My mother's Sarah. Name is Sarah.
Okay, this is about to get real good.
What?
David and Sarah, two Jewish names.
David and Sarah, two names right out of the Bible, which has got nothing to do with the Jews.
Now, you don't want to get uptight about it, Mr. Bunker. There's nothing to be ashamed of being Jewish.
But I ain't Jewish.
Look at that. Look at that. See the way he uses his hands when he argues? Very Semitic gesture.
What do you know about it, you dumb Pollock? You sure are. You're a Polack joke.
I don't mind, though. I'm Polish. I don't mind. I'm proud of it.
Now, there you are, Mr. Bunker. Now, you ought to be proud you're Jewish.
But I ain't Jewish.
He's not. I didn't know. He's not trying to be either.
You was Jewish?
What the hell are you talking about? You of all people should know that I ain't Jewish.
You are talking with your hands.
You see, the Jews tend to be emotional.
Now listen to me, Lionel. I'm going to give you this once more, and that's all.
I am not Jewish. Yes, sir, Mr. Bunker. But even if you are, it doesn't change things between you and me. I mean, I'm not going to throw away 9 years of friendship over a little thing like that.
Let me turn this down a little bit.
These people asked us to dinner on.
Well, now that you know I got tickets for the Mets, you can call these people up and cancel me.
She can't do that, Daddy. These people, they wouldn't understand.
These people? Who are these people?
For real.
Tell him, Ma. Oh, that's all right. You tell him, dear. I won't mind.
Well, come on. Somebody better tell me. Who the hell are they?
It's the Jeffersons, Archie.
Oh, who are the Jeffersons? Oh, wait a minute. Hold. You don't mean them new people that moved in down the front?
Yeah, Lionel's family. They're really very nice people.
Oh, yeah, very nice. They're wonderful people. They're lovely people, Lita, but they are also colored people.
Oh, wow.
Better hold it there, Daddy.
Now, listen, little girl. Been around a lot of places. I've done a lot of things, but there's one thing Archie Bunker ain't never going to do, and that's break bread with no jungle bunnies.
Stop. We may not even
Jeez.
There's somebody else up for the job, and he happens to be black.
Oh, well, then you're off to mend the shoulder of black.
Well, let me turn it up a little bit.
I ain't going nowhere.
Archie, these days, colleges are hiring blacks over whites.
Confused.
Well, it is high time.
Oh,
better believe it. You better believe it. You shouldn't go out there and take a job away from that guy. Oh, it turns out that you're the guy against the colored. I never was.
Wow.
I want to go on record as saying something right here or not. It was up to me. I'd send every colored guy in New York to Minnesota.
Yeah, Jefferson? That ain't very nice, talking that way to your little mammy here.
We saw that one. I'm going to skip forward on this one because we already saw all this. And if you haven't seen it, make sure you check out the playlist. Again, we did this one, so yes, yeah, push it on to the next.
You get my inviting wife.
Interested in your wife is sitting on one of the hottest murder trials in the country.
Ah, what's so hot about it? I ain't got better murders on the Late Show. This thing is an open shut case.
Oh, wait a minute. I admit it doesn't look too good for Rodriguez, but that doesn't
listen,
mean it's
listen,
open and
listen,
shut.
Listen. DA nailed the coffin down on that guy yesterday. Now, there's two witnesses seen him go home to his apartment house up in Spanish Harlem. Another witness seen him go into the apartment. All right, he goes in there. He finds his old lady in there with another sprig.
Wow.
What does he do? Whips out his switchblade and zap. Sends him to that big taco stand up in the sky.
So bad.
But what do you expect? I mean, look at the way those Puerto Ricans are caged up in those slums. It's no wonder the tension builds.
You don't like it there, let him get out of there. I ain't making him live there.
His pal Roger is as queer as a Ford.
This is all bad.
Who knows?
That's not only cruel, Daddy, that's an outright lie.
You know something, Archie? Just because a guy is sensitive and he's an intellectual and he wears glasses, you make him out a queer.
I never said a guy who wears glasses is a queer. A guy who wears glasses is a four eyes. A guy who is a fag is a queer.
In a couple minutes.
That's just stupid.
At least he clears it up for you, so you understand exactly what he means.
Yeah, Jefferson.
Besides, getting elected, there's more to that than just being smart.
There is, huh? Then how come we don't have a black president? I mean, some of our black people are just as dumb as Nixon.
You ain't got a black president, Jefferson, because God ain't ready for that yet.
Wow.
Wait a second. What?
That's right. God's got to try it out first by making a black pope, which he ain't done yet.
So dumb.
Or maybe that's because God ain't Catholic.
We know that line.
Can't you men change the subject?
Yeah, Gloria's right. This is no time
I'm
to be...
I'm talking, Michael.
Oh, boy.
No. Uh-oh.
Is that all you can talk about? Whether a black man or a white man should be president?
Well, what do you want to talk about, little girl?
How about a woman president?
Oh, holy cow.
A woman president?
Mr. Jefferson, this may come as a big surprise to you, but women are much more oppressed than blacks.
And Mr. Jefferson, so who exactly is this? Because obviously it's not George Jefferson. So does he have any relations to that? Let me know. Put it in the comments. I'm kind of confused about that.
You know, ghetto for women.
What do you call a kitchen?
I call it a prison.
Stay out of this, Louise. You're talking foolish.
Do you know what Shirley Chisholm said? Shirley Chisholm said that she ran into more discrimination because she was a woman than because she was black.
That's why she didn't get elected.
Right.
Because she was talking foolish.
Oh, wow.
Mr. Jefferson, she wasn't talking foolish. The business world has been doing this.
So there was two different Jeffersons, right? As in the actor. I gotta figure this out. Y'all gotta help me out. Please let me know.
Same thing to us now that they've been doing to you. They're hiring token women.
Well, by the same token, hire one for me.
So dumb.
It's not funny, Michael.
I'll see you later. The whole point I'm trying to make is that you take these things like what do you call loyal and love. Well, yet your colored families, they don't feel them things like your colorless families.
Wow.
I got something to say. Gather on, everybody. I'm going to make a toast to Archie.
Nice. Right. Toast for my daddy.
It's been a great experience living on this street and watching this wonderful family of Edith, Gloria, and Mike.
I want to thank you, Bunker, for letting me know and letting me see that some white folks are better than other white folks.
Oh, stupid.
Oh, no! While the Estradas are thinking it over, you and Henry are trying to find somebody else to buy the house.
You don't call that crooked? No! That's looking out for number one.
Where does that place Henry Jefferson?
Them shorts.
Number two. Why is he number two? Because, meathead, there can only be one number one and one number two. And life made Jefferson number two long before I come along.
So I suppose that the Puerto Ricans are number three, then, hmm?
Well, no, not necessarily there, little girl. Your Puerto Ricans could be four. Your Japs and your Chins could be three. 3A, 3B.
So messed up.
Now, you're being colored. Well, I know you had no choice in that. But whatever made you turn Jew?
His face.
I was just remembering the last time I seen you on TV. It was on a Johnny Carson show.
Oh, yeah.
He was on with that there Raquel Walsh. Remember, Edith?
Oh, yeah, I remember. Oh, you were so sweet to her, Mr. Davis.
Oh, thank you.
Archie said he never thought he'd see the day when coloreds and whites would be hugging and kissing coast to coast.
That's mean, Archie, but you see, it's not me.
I gotta watch this full episode of Sammy Davis Jr.
Do they put a kissing clause in my contract?
Huh?
Well, you see, it's those white celebrities. Well, this year we're in, so they all want to jump on the bandwagon.
That was a good one.
You mean to tell me the networks force you to kiss against your will?
Well, what are you gonna do?
Oh, well, that ain't right, Sam. I mean, you know, to force the races to intersex that way on the air? Now, no prejudice intended, but, you know, I always check with the Bible on these here things.
Oh.
Yeah, I think that, I mean, if God had meant us to be together, he'd have put us together. Well, look what he done. He put you over in Africa, he put the rest of us in all the white countries.
Whoa! Yeah, exactly. Exactly that.
Well, you must have told him where we were because somebody came and got it. I mean, there was work for us. I mean, and how could you resist? Free transportation, room, board, chains.
So dumb.
I think you're talking about slavery there, Sam. I want to tell you that I was always dead set against slavery. You see what goes on around here, Sammy? Every time I start to have a serious conversation, these kids go crazy. Another thing they're always doing to me, they're always telling me I'm prejudiced. Now listen, you're a guy who's been around a lot. You've seen a lot of people, yeah. You know a lot, see? Yeah. Now you look at me. You figure me for a prejudiced guy?
Oh, Archie, you don't tell me you're really paying attention to those young kids. What do they know? I mean, you prejudice. Look, if you were prejudiced, Archie, when I came into your house, you would have called me a coon or a nigger. But you didn't say that. I heard you clear as a bell. Right straight out, you said, colored.
Yeah, that's what I done, all right.
And if you were prejudiced, you would, like some people, close their eyes to what's going on in this great country that we live in. But not you, Archie. Your eyes are wide open. You can tell the difference between black and white.
Stupid.
And I have a deep-rooted feeling that you'll always be able to tell the difference between black and white. And if you were prejudiced, you'd walk around thinking that you're better than anybody else in the world. But I can honestly say, having spent these marvelous moments with you, you ain't better than anybody.
Stupid.
Can I have your hand on that, Sam? And I hope you all heard that over there. That comes straight from Sammy Davis Jr., Mr. Wonderful himself. And that should prove to you once and for all that I ain't prejudiced.
This one is for me. Mr. Munson, when you stand over there, I want one picture taken with Archie Bunker, my friend,
we
and me.
We saw this one.
Yes. Now, on three, okay? One, two, three.
Got him good. Yeah, I remember seeing that one.
But while we're on the subject of looks, you're gonna play Santa Claus. You know, Santa Claus was white and so was his beard.
Told you to say that, Uncle Henry.
That's ridiculous. I'd look silly with a white beard. And who said Santa Claus was white?
Oh, come on now. I had the same argument with you about Jesus.
I wish I saw that one.
Go over all ground again, but the fact is Jesus is white and so is Santa Claus.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, let me tell you something, Bucko. When I was a kid on Christmas Eve, the guy that used to fill my stocking was black.
Well, let me tell you something.
We ought to get going. You know the kids down at the center, Uncle Henry. Come on, let's go, Ma. Hey.
Okay, gotta turn this down again because the volume's terrible.
And what about you, sir?
Scotch and soda, please.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Jefferson, there's a switch for you. This guy giving you the big yes, sir.
Why? He's a bartender, ain't
he? Yeah, but what I meant was I'm used to having it the other way around.
Oh, yeah? How many servants you got in that mansion you living in?
What do you mean by that?
Let me tell you something about people.
There you are.
Thank you. That bartender's willing to work for me because if you got enough green in your pocket, then black becomes his favorite color.
Wow.
The way you are.
All right, back to turning it up. I'm sorry, y'all.
Hey, Lindsay, he runs the city's transportation system. A working man could get home for supper around breakfast time.
Now, look, Arch, we're gonna
say one thing for Mussolini. He was no bundle of laughs, but he sure could make a train run on time.
Hi.
Hey.
Oh, hey, if you're looking for the Elks Club, stop.
We saw this one too, actually. He's dating a black woman. So we saw that one. If you want to see those, all you got to do is check out the playlist because we have already seen those. Anyways, all right, so Travis, I will have to say this was quite a bit longer than I expected. And I know I didn't talk that much. I just pretty much wowed it because I was. Yeah, you showed me why this couldn't air. I remember asking and not understanding. I understand it now. Some of it was in good taste, in my opinion. Some of it seemed more for just shock value, but I think they could have toned it down a little bit, in my personal opinion, and it would still be just as funny. So, it is what it is. Anyways, if you're making it this far, you might as well hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that comment button. Let me know your favorite All in the Family episode and what else you want to see me react to. If you're already doing that and making it this far, then I got to say thank you. Please don't forget about my music. Again, links to that is right underneath the like button. Same as if you want to be part of the unboxing reactions, all you got to do is send me something, the P.O. Box address. Is in the description. And with all that being said, you know I'll be back at it with another reaction tomorrow.